Hello and welcome. My name is Joe, and I am the Panic Monk, and you are watching Lost in Time, a Dwemer's Tale. In this episode, we are picking up in Labyrinthian, where we left off. We have just come out of Shelador's maze in search of the Staff of Magnus. Our hero has been led to believe that this staff will help him control the Eye of Magnus and bring him back to his people. Or bring his people to him, I guess. He's not entirely sure which is which, but I think the assumption would be that he would be brought back to his people, or at least given a direction on how he can find them. This idea has been kind of implanted through this creature, this banished one that pops up in his dreams and his thoughts, although he is not 100% positive where the ideas are coming from, as he can't really pinpoint the source of this banished one. So he's kind of thinking that they're his own thoughts. We talked about this a little bit prior, so I won't dwell on it too much, but there is nothing in here that Sanak is interested in picking up. This is an old Nordic ruin, and he just doesn't feel that disturbing these pieces right now is probably very prudent. So we are going to continue to the other side of this ruin, this stronghold, whatever it might have been, city, and see if maybe we can have some better luck on this other side. There has been nothing so far. He's tried two different areas of Labyrinthian, neither which have been fruitful in his search, so let's check this out. Many places left to look, but this looks promising. Hold on. Who are you? Who are all of you?
Come on. We're finally here. Let's not waste any more time.
Are we truly sure this is a good idea?
We'll be back at the college before anyone even knows we're gone.
What is this?
You would care about that, since you're the Archmage's favorite.
Don't forget, this whole idea was Atmos to begin with.
Is this some sort of memory?
Let's just get inside, see what's in there.
Archmage. Of course he won't hear me. What is this? What was that? This does not bode well. But I do believe we are probably on the right trail. One way to find out. In the name of Oblivion. What happened here? Trying to get out? By Numidium.
What is this place? Oh, something terrible happened here. Yes, they're all trying to escape. From what? All of them. Oh, Savos. Where have you led me? These are not just simple ghosts.
I can't believe we're doing this.
Can you imagine the looks on their faces when we come back?
You keep talking like you're sure we'll find something useful in here.
Given the history of this place, it's more than likely there's still some amount of power here.
What were you looking for?
Enchanted weapons, tomes of ancient knowledge, Shalador's secrets themselves. Who knows what we could find?
And what if there are things guarding this place?
Against 6 college-trained mages? I think we'll be fine.
That is foolish thinking. Never underestimate. Especially when you don't know what you're up against. Look at these books. Well then. I guess we move forward. Caution. Caution, I do believe, would be prudent. Although nothing so far. What do we have here? Uh-oh. Something's amiss. Come on, sorcerer. I think I'm going to need your help. Let's have a little peek first, shall we? See what you stir up. Well, something, I hear creaking. Ah, skeletons. Ooh, and a mage. And an archer. Ah. Well done. Is in there. Oh, there's something else in there. Let's see if we can try something here. ghost walk. I see. This gate is going to trap me if I'm not careful. So, I think it's all about timing. Flip the gate, ghost walk, through the gate, so that when I reappear, I'm on this side. Let's try this again. Certainly there's something in there to stir up. Numidium, what is that? Frost. Get it. Oh, it's smart, whatever it is. Come on. Come on. Coax it out of there. Where are you? See you. Look out, sorcerer. Sorcerer. I've got nothing I can coax that thing. It's just out of range. See if we can draw it out. It's staying in the shadows. I can't reach it from here with my spells. I can try one more time. No. It's too far. It's just too far. Come on, sorcerer. No. Damn. Okay, well that didn't work. One more time. I can't get a good bead on it in time. Ugh, way too high. Should have done it. No. Alright, let's go. Come on, you. Come on, follow me. Ah. Bam. So cold. I see you. I think I can get you now. Come on. Ah, thank you, sorcerer. Come on, there you are. Ah, gotcha. Oh boy, what else lies down here? Good job, Sorcerer. Let's get this gate up. Make it safe to move. Let's hurry to the other end, just in case.
Looks like I must have turned my lights off during the back and forth with that particular undead dragon, so now that we've got him back on, let's keep going. That's a table of some sort. Let's check it out.
We have to go back. We can't leave Gerduin.
We barely made it out alive.
What was that?
You want to go back in?
It's too late. There isn't enough of him left to go back in after.
Gods, what have we done?
Indeed, what have you done?
Might as well go forward. We can still do this.
Savos is right. We can make it if we just
stay alert. Savos, you fool. Cut your losses. Leave. I want to venture too far without some help. Oh, that one takes a toll, however. All right, Sorcerer. Follow. Follow me. What's that? Oh, wait. Look across. It's still dormant. All right. Let's get rid of it. Lucky. That could have easily come up on our back. Oh, it's tied to that. Frost, ice crystals. Okay, I think I understand. What's this? Book of Fire. It's nothing we don't already know. Let's make certain. Yes, this should do it. Come on, break it up. Perfect. See what's up ahead. What? What? Is that? Need us hit. Oh, Sabos. You lit something up. Its eyes. Come on, sorcerer. Take it down. Take it down. Take it down. Perfect. Ooh, look at that sword. It's huge. Definitely avoid getting hit by that. There's something not good down here. Come on, sorcerer. Come on. Ah, more of these things. But where? Ah, down there. Oh, it's a spellcaster, I think. Oh, sorcerer. Stuck. It's an imprecise spell. Works more often than not, so I'm not complaining. Come on, get him. Come on, come on out. I can't get him from this ledge. The angle's all wrong. No. It's too far in. Perfect. Well done. Well done. Now what? Oh, there's more. There's more. There he is, Archer. Still hear another. How many are there? Aha. I see you. Gotcha. No. Tough. Now you come up. All right, what's down here? can leave nothing undiscovered. So stupid. That's it. Get it. Go on. There you go. Huh. You must have been hit by that rune. Ancient Nords liked their large weapons, didn't they? Okay, well, this is a good find. Though, I'm not sure what I can make. No. I'm not gonna bog myself down with books I don't need. These all look salvageable, though. Right, what can I do? What can I do? Health would be nice, but I haven't the ingredients. Resist fire, I guess, can never hurt. No. All right. That could be useful. Alright, that's about all I can do here. I just don't have the ingredients I need to do anything all that useful. Nothing down here. Deeper. Deeper I have to go.
You guttural language of yours.
Something in here. Oh, damn it.
So with all of these little points of this whatever it is that's basically telling us to just go away, this voice, not sure what it is. Some sort of powerful entity that has made this its home, or perhaps was the reason that this was built. By all rights, if we were smart, we would just go away, but Sanak fortunately is pretty focused right now on the mission of obtaining this staff, and he can't afford to let a warning beacon like that deter him. So all right, see if we can take this thing out. Fortunately, I mean, for Draugr, they have not been terribly aggressive quite as of yet. I don't think the Frost Atronach was probably the best option. They're ancient Nords, so being a Nord, they're going to have some sort of frost resistance to begin with, and not to mention they're also undead or, you know, reanimated, so I think there's going to be a certain amount of frost resistance there as well, so not the best choice. But what Frost Atronachs are good at is blocking. They're so big that they can really clog up a narrow space pretty quick. Come on, get up there, get up there. So I do like them for that ability or that attribute, that they're just so massive that if you get one in between you and your foes in a narrow, tight spot, it'll at least buy you a little bit of time. Well, that's where you fell. But in this instance, as I had mentioned, probably not the best choice damage-wise. I don't think their frost abilities or their frost damage is going to have a huge effect. Fire. Fire is probably the way to go if I'm going to do an Atronach, an elemental that is. I think that the undead. I think the undead Draugr. What was that? Oh. It thinks we're someone else. Huh. Alright. What was I saying? Something about fire and Draugr. Pretty much anything is susceptible to fire. Most things are, at least. Well, maybe not Dunmer so much, but if you're going to pick an elemental, that one's probably going to have the broadest effect on most things. But the frost on those things that are affected by them is pretty damn handy. It'll drain the stamina, it will slow them down. It has some pretty good advantages, some good effects. God, they're big though. Dang. Alright, where are you going off to? Which can also be a problem because they can block your exits too, or prevent you from going anywhere. Or they can get stuck and can't follow you. Now the Zivilai, being more of a human-sized or an average size, doesn't have that effect as much. They would just get in the way like a normal follower. Stripey shadows. Alright, I think there's something up there. Let's see. Oh, hell yeah. But I do like this Zivilai with the range. I'm not sure what it casts. It almost looks like some kind of poison type of energy blast that has a lingering effect. I'm not sure. I haven't looked much up on it. But that's what it seems to have, some kind of poison delayed effect to it. Which is alright. I'll take it. Alright, well, takes care of whatever that was. Ah, Skelly. Skelly-welly. Leave no gate unturned, unlocked. Here. It doesn't look like it, to be honest. But I don't know how far down that goes, so. Kind of our go-to infiltration mode. Oh, yeah, that doesn't really help, does it? Alright, well. Not sure why that would have been locked, but okay. Let's see. This is where we came from. Alright. That's the dead end. Here we go. Seek to finish that which you could not. So Savos definitely ran into something pretty damn powerful. That sounds like what? Sounds like a troll, actually. So this little merry band of mages, led by Savos, definitely came into some unexpected problems. Alright, let's go check this out. See if we're right. One-handed ghost walk does not last terribly long. But if we can push our sorcerer in front of us a little bit, maybe he can. No. Alright. Give us sell ourselves a little bit more time here. Oh, there he is, there he is. Found him. Yeah, it's probably good timing out, honestly. Come on, sorcerer, get in there. Do it. Do it! Do it now! Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I usually do a much better Arnold impression than that, but I think we'll just leave it at that. Boop, 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 boop. Ooh, we're gonna get ourselves in the corner. Damn it. I think our sorcerer materialized just in time to save our bacon. Snack definitely has a tendency to let his conjurations do their thing without getting in the way. Either getting in their way or them getting in his way, so unfortunately these trolls are kind of tough. Come on, do it, do it, do it. It's just out of view. I can't reach it from here, but I can give it a try, I guess. Problem is, I don't want to hit the sorcerer either. Yeah, see, I don't think I'm hitting him. Oh, maybe I am. It's just whether or not I'm doing enough damage to compensate for their healing. I'm not convinced that I am. And it's just some kind of weird standoff. Alright, looks like we're going to have to poke and prod things a little bit. There we go. That thing doesn't want to come out of there, does it? Which is going to work to our advantage. Excellent. Oh, I'm not going to be carrying a bunch of troll fat and skulls and all the hides. I mean, it's great stuff you can use to smith with. However, it's just way too heavy. And Sanaka's not down here to gather materials. He's focused on getting the staff and stopping and taking the extra time it would take to skin a troll is just nothing he's going to do right now. That is not part of the plan at the moment. Alright, so this is just kind of the troll's lair. What's this? This goes...
You only face failure once more.
It's a big talker. Our blue cloud of etherealness. So that goes down. That's where we came from. Let's take a peek. This poor soul didn't fare too well. Probably an adventurer. The bones picked clean by our friendly troll cave dweller. What's down here? Let's see if we can find a spot and get our sorcerer down there without us actually having to go down there. There's actually a lot of spots to cast through here, so hopefully we can do that. Draw anything out that might be waiting for us. It's kind of a big open spot. That can be good and bad. Alright, where'd you go? Oop, I hear you. How do we get... Oh, no more trolls. Oh, there he is. Come on. Ew. That's not good. Let's get another one down there. Is that Frost? What's casting that? I didn't cast the Wraith by chance. No, the Wraith casts like little energy balls. I'm getting up here because I'm not sure what might come up this corridor. Still something happening down here. I mean, this is a good big open space where a person can run around and keep away from the trolls, which are a little bit slower. But there's also not many places to hide. And if there's an archer or a spellcaster, it's going to be tough to close the ground before they can get a lot of good whacks in on you. So I do like the fact that there were some openings up above that we could kind of vet this a little bit. Alright, looks like our sorcerer took care of something. We know it took care of a troll. What else did it... I think there was a like some sort of wraith or something down here that was...
Aaron, are you?
No, I'm not Aaron.
This has sent you in his place.
That's just disconcerting. Anyway, it looked like there was something down there that cast some kind of frost spell, so. This looks ripe for an ambush. Oop, oop, oop. Ouch. Alright, sorcerer, you gonna go and get that? I have a feeling our sorcerer just got... whacked. Oh, no. Okay, well, get out of the way. Come on. Alright, there we go. So that would lead me to believe that he took this thing down. My Akato's recital spell kicking off would tell me otherwise. As with that. Now the sorcerer is a great conjuration and has become kind of my go-to for now. It does deal some damage when you cast it. It's kind of what it does. I believe it's fire damage, actually. But he has a good range. He's got that delayed damage ball of poison, for lack of a better term, and is pretty tough, I guess. However, as you can see, not the smartest. It's not the smartest conjuration. I think actually the Avenging Wraith, I feel is a little bit brighter and will make attempts to engage your enemies and can figure out how to kind of get around things, but for some reason, this civilized sorcerer has a tendency to get himself stuck. And will kind of just hang out around corners without actually going around the corner. But, you know, it's a trade-off, I guess. little bit more powerful spell casting than the Wraith. Definitely has a much longer, a much longer duration, even just single casting, which is really helpful. A lot of trolls down here. Okay, I'm not going to take ingots again. Kind of a weight thing. Especially iron. Can probably pick those up pretty easily anywhere. I will say though, man, that the sorcerer's spell, when it impacts, can really throw things all over the place. Just kind of funny. I'm pretty sure this thing was not casting a frost spell. I could have swore that I saw something. Maybe not. Or it's just... I don't know. It might just be hidden. Who knows? I'm not going to search too far and wide. I'm not that curious. Alright, what's down here now? Oop, there's our spellcaster. Ouch, ouch. Come on. Alright, close the gate, close the gate, close the gate. Come on, close the gate. Okay. Now, the sorcerer should have followed us in, unless it was dissipated, or... And we'll throw one in there just in case. He should be able to take care of that thing pretty quickly. Oh yeah. God, I love that.
What's that? What is that? What is that sound? Whoa, whoa. Are those anomalies, like, back at the college? I can't tell from here. No, I don't think so. I think they would be much more aggressive if they were. Let's send you in there without actually going in there. Come on, I'm gonna find a point to... Whoa, 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 whoa! Definitely not the anomalies. Definitely not the anomalies. What else is in there? Something has you all. Oh, what are you? Standoff do we have here? Bring it down, bring it down. quite see, but I don't want to get too close to the fray. Ah, perfect. Excellent. Some sort of core. What is this place? The graves? He must have missed that part. Okay.
Alright. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this has been a bit longer episode. The next one will be about the same length, about 60 minutes. So I just kind of wanted to get through Labyrinthian here with you. And I figured the best way to do that is to keep the episodes a little bit longer. So, with that, we're going to open up this door, and we will continue our way through Labyrinthian in the next episode. Thanks for joining me, and until next time, safe journeys.